Hi, in this video, I'm going to be talking about antiperspirant and breast cancer. Is there a link between the two? Before I go on, I want to encourage you to subscribe to this channel. We put out 3 videos a week, so it's likely there'll be something of interest to you fairly regularly. So a lot of people have asked us, is there a connection between antiperspirant, deodorant, and breast cancer? First, I'm going to start by defining the difference between deodorant and antiperspirant, just to be super clear about what we're talking about. Deodorant is something we put on to diminish or cover up what might be considered unwanted scents at common places that people put. Antiperspirant or deodorant is under their arms. So that's what we'll be talking about today. The difference between deodorant and antiperspirant is that antiperspirant actually decreases the amount of sweating or moisture that we create under the arms. So deodorant just covers up the scent, and antiperspirant actually cuts down on the production of sweat that, when affected by bacteria, can become malodorous or bad smelling. The reason there has been a concern, at least in the lay press, between antiperspirant and breast cancer is that the thought is, because we're putting something under the arm, that we might be interfering with the lymphatics. So I'm going to take an aside and talk about the lymphatic system for just a moment. The lymphatic circulation is circulation just like our bloodstream. It's actually a beautiful, elaborate connection network of lymphatic channels and lymph nodes that run throughout our whole body. And every part of the body is drained by a certain set of lymph nodes. So for example, if I have an infection on my hand, depending on the infection, that could be drained up my arm to a lymph node near my elbow, up to my underarm. If I have an infection above my palate or in my sinuses, that area drains to the lymph nodes here in my neck. And we can see the front lymph nodes right here get swollen or tender in strep throat or sinus infections or just a regular virus that causes an upper respiratory infection like a cold. We have lymph nodes in our abdomen that drain the abdominal organs and drain the legs. So the lymphatics are all over our body. Nobody really knows how many lymph nodes a given person has because it varies between all of us. And if we have an infection or something else going on that shouldn't be in our body, we can actually recruit more lymph nodes. So in an area that looks like it has only 8 lymph nodes, when it's stimulated, there could be many more lymph nodes. So we have lymph nodes under our arm that drain the breast. And the concern was that by putting something in the sweat glands, that we would be increasing the risk of breast cancer. I'm pleased to say that hasn't been borne out to be true. And in fact, even the lay press is much less likely to publish information like that. The way antiperspirants work, let's take an aluminum containing antiperspirant. It puts a little aluminum plug inside the gland that sweats under the arm. So you'll notice a lot of antiperspirants have aluminum in them. And the concern was that there would be influx of those chemicals into the breast. And that's why, theoretically, people were concerned about the connection between antiperspirants and breast cancer. But there is no evidence in large numbers of people that this is the case. And the primary reason is that we don't absorb things through the glands. We actually excrete things out of the glands. In addition, there are no known carcinogens in antiperspirants or deodorants, for that matter. It doesn't mean that you need to use an antiperspirant. If you are using breast cancer risk as a reason not to, it's perfectly fine. But if you've used an antiperspirant your whole life, or friends of yours do, or your children do, you can rest assured that there's no connection between antiperspirants and breast, or frankly, other cancers. I hope this has been helpful. If it has, click like, subscribe to our channel, drop a comment or question below. You may have other questions about the health of the skin in your armpit. We'd love to entertain those as well. Thanks for watching.